In the 1940s, the United States modified tanks for nuclear testing. An M3 Grant had its weapons removed and cameras installed to film the blast. But the real work was done by the so-called atomic Shermans, specially adapted to collect soil samples from ground zero. They first appeared at Trinity, the world's first nuclear explosion, on July 16, 1945. The Army wanted hard data. What had the bomb done to the Earth? Two Shermans were lined with lead to shield their crews, then sent toward the crater. The first method was direct. A Sherman would drive as close as possible, and crewmen would scoop soil through a floor hatch, breathing from air tanks. In case of breakdown, a second Sherman stood ready to tow it out. The second method was safer. Special launchers on the back of a Sherman fired rockets, each equipped with a small scoop and a cable. The rocket flew about 450 meters into the crater, then was hauled back by the cable, with the scoop now filled with soil. Each shot brought back around 0.5 kilograms of radioactive earth. According to reports, one Sherman got within 91 meters of the epicenter just hours after the blast. Soldiers recalled the ground fused into green glass, later called trinitite. On a later run, the tank reached the crater itself. Even with lead armor, radiation inside was extreme, and the crew absorbed dangerous doses. The rocket method, though, worked smoothly. Five were launched, four returned with excellent samples, while one Sherman eventually broke down in the danger zone. Despite the risks, the Shermans gave scientists the first precise measurements of a nuclear explosion's efficiency. Later tests relied more on remote-controlled vehicles, but at Trinity, it was tanks that braved ground zero.